So in the last episode of SpaceVidcast, it was mentioned that the Chinese space program was progressing really fast because they seemed to go directly from the Gemini stage straight to Skylab in only a few years. Thing is, that's just not true. The problem some people seem to have is that they think of the Chinese space program as if it were a knockoff of the American space program, but it isn't. It's a knockoff of the Soviet space program. So what happens when you look at Chinese space efforts in these terms? The first Chinese satellite, Dongfang Hong 1, was launched in 1970, whereas Sputnik 1 was launched in 1957. It took the Soviets 4 years to launch their first human into orbit. That happened in 1961 with Yuri Gagarin. It took the Chinese 33 years to do the same. They launched Shenzhou 5 in 2003. The first Soviet spacewalk came less than 4 years after their first manned flight, in 1965. The Chinese program moved at a similar pace, delivering the first EVA in just under 5 years. Shenzhou 7 was launched in 2008. The first Soviet space station, Salyut 1, was launched in 1971, 10 years and 1 week after their first manned flight. Its first crew launched 3 days later on Soyuz 10. The first Chinese space station, Tiangong 1, was launched in 2011, 8 years after their first manned flight. Its first crew was launched in 2012 on Shenzhou 9. It's somewhat important to understand that the Soviet Union had conducted a total of 18 manned flights by this stage in their program, launching 29 people into orbit, whereas China has so far launched 4 manned missions with a total of 9 people having flown. This is why I don't think it's unreasonable for me to request that the people in the comments section please tone down their China worship. Thank you.